fucking building.
Face no
case. Face Jersey in a building.
Jersey in a building.
You know what I'm saying? What's going on, brother? Got a lot of music out there doing his numbers. What's going on, brother?
Not much, man. Traffic was crazy today.
Always crazy on a Friday.
Y'all niggas left 4 hours early this time?
Something like that.
Because last time, y'all niggas...
Something like that.
Niggas was like, yo, the bike chain went off and I had to pedal faster.
Nah.
Nah, what's going on, though, man?
Nah, man, I'm chilling, man. We came out here.
That's what's up.
Talk about the new shit we got going on and whatnot.
Yeah, so, what's the new shit?
About to drop my first mixtape in about a month from now. It's called Face Season. So, yeah. And
okay,
you know what I'm saying? Other than that, I mean, we got a lot of music out right now. Doing all right. We just started this shit like 3 weeks ago, so the shit kind of doing pretty well. It just had started.
Yeah, I heard that you like just started rapping type shit.
Word, man. I just started rapping. I was in college and shit, and then I came home.
Fuck, you tore a ligament on the field or some shit, and was like, you know what? Rapping might be.
That might be it.
Word, what like, made you decide to start wanting to rapping and all that shit?
You know what's funny? Growing up, I used to do it a lot. My cousins, my uncles say like that. But the thing was, I was type shy. I never thought I would, you know what I'm saying? You know like how you do something?
Move a crowd and shit like that?
Yeah, I don't even know.
I wasn't with that.
If and it's going to pop or not.
Where it's like everybody else wave, and I'm like, I'm trying to do the school thing, the sport thing. That's what I was into. Feel me?
So
and
now you're fully focused on rap.
Word. Okay, okay. I'm not even going back to school this next semester.
Like. Don't say shit like that. Like,
right.
Yeah, come on, brother. We got education is the key, brother.
It is the key. But when you know
said that shit kind of blunt. Like, I ain't even going the fuck back. Got my homies over here. You got a backpack on. I don't know why.
It ain't for everybody. You know, I would always encourage kids to stay in school.
Okay.
But it ain't for everybody.
Nah, you true. You right about that.
You got a plan. And you know what you need to do and how to execute it. That's what you do.
You all right? Cause Bill Gates didn't go. I mean, he went to school, but he didn't graduate. Yeah.
A lot of motherfuckers ain't go.
And if you got an idea, I mean, go for it. For real, man.
Shit is really all based on hustle, man.
Yeah.
Right.
Word. That's what's up. What was your major when you was in there?
Word. Actually, I was going to school to be in the medical field, nursing field. I was like, I was a pharmacy technician and whatnot.
So my son was trying to be the chemist.
Word.
The plug on the low.
Type shit.
Look, he was trying to be the plug. I got that cook up.
That had crystal meth going 8.
Oh wow!
He like chill. I still know my professor. Chill.
I was like nah, hold on, chill.
That's what's up. So like in 2-3 weeks, a month maybe.
Yeah, this upcoming week is a month. I think Friday today. Actually today made a month that I've been doing this.
What kind of response you begin so far?
Everything been well. Actually, I spoke to. You know what's funny? My social media period, like not trying, it's starting to go a little wild. The views, I think right now the most I got on views on something, it's probably like 11,000 and like 6 views.
Good.
It's only
been like I said 3 weeks, and I haven't really promoted that at all. It's just for the people in my town, they mess with it. The clubs let me come in there even though I'm underage. They let me perform, do my thing. That's just what it is right now.
That's what's
the hip hop scene out there in Patterson, New Jersey? They like it seems like they fuck with you, they fuck with you.
Yeah, if they don't fuck with you,
it's quiet.
It's real quiet.
Type shit.
Real quiet. Other than Fetty, I mean, it's probably like 2 other cats I know that's doing anything out there. It's this kid named JoJo. I mean, shout out to him, RGF, and then they also got my man's I forgot his name, Vlad, something like that. But he nice.
Mm-hmm.
I went to school,
huh? Nice. So what was everybody's reaction when you first came to them? Like your squad, people you hang out with, your peers?
When I told my peers, they looked at me like, you doing what? Let me hear it. Because like I said, I was never that type. You never would even expect that from me. I was a kid who always just got by, did what he had to do, and always stayed in the shadows. Feel me? So me doing this and starting to see how the game worked and whatnot, It's different. It's a whole different scenario, like, you know.
How was that booth experience then?
You said what?
How was that booth experience? Me and
oh,
that, you
man.
Say you the shy, you know what I mean? Sometimes tight.
Took my first, you know what's funny? The first, because it's like every beat that I do or purchase and whatever I do, I already pre-plan what I'm going to do on it. So when I got in there, it was a little nerve-wracking at first. But the truth is, I went through it so many times. It was like when I got in there, the first 2 songs, I got them 2.5.
Nice.
Like, it depends on what flows I'm doing.
You got any studio preferences? Like, yo, nobody in the, only me and the engineer, turn the light off.
Actually, not really. I mean, I allow my peoples to be in there because I like them to see, get the vibe from it. A lot of my music is vibe music. You know what I'm saying? So definitely, and when a mixtape come out, definitely shoot it through so y'all can listen to it. See if y'all feeling it or not. Got a couple of songs I think y'all might like. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
What you trying to achieve once you make the tape and start making your rhyme? What's your main focus on digging in the rap game?
Once I get in, it's just to stay consistent. To be honest, other than that though, it's even to go farther than that. It's about the rap too, but it's just about the brand and what I'm trying to do, not just for me, but how I could reach out to the world and reach out to my peers and even older heads. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just to reach out to everybody and, you know, especially the kids around my age, especially how we rocking, how things going on with us. You know what I'm saying? So just to show them, you know, you don't got to make necessarily trap music. You don't got to make, you know what I'm saying? You could do it in a positive way at the same token.
Yeah, I see you like diversify your shit. Like, your shit ain't straight trap. Like,
nah.
You more or less like edge and toes R&B, but it's like kind of a mixture of it.
Yeah, sound like a... I mean, in my lane, I pretty like a P&B, like a P&B rock.
That's the type
lane I'm in. Yeah. Bryson Tiller type lane.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Bryson Tiller.
Yeah, he trying to go out.
You find out you ready to hit that note on BBA radio today.
He trying to go out the hoes, man. Right.
Word of the.
Right, you can't never lose going with the women, though.
Definitely can.
Look. She look like she ready to buy your shit. Tell me what you are to me, baby. Tell me something. Hey, don't make me get this singing out this motherfucker.
Right.
Chill.
Yo, you know what? It's all gravy, me. My debut album come out. I'm telling you, say. Nah. What else, though, man? You ain't got a team with your...
Yeah, I mean, my cameraman engineer is supposed to be on their way, but, you know, we coming from where we come from. So
what's the name of your team, like?
Team Face No Case for me. So shout out to them.
Okay.
They all at home probably.
Nice.
Oh, Team Face. So y'all shit is Face No Case.
Yeah, it's Face No Case. I'm Face.
You Face.
Team Face No Case. You feel me?
Oh, all right.
Where, and that's Zay over there. That's Zay. And that's Travis.
Shout out to them.
Shout out to Zay. That's my homie for real. He do a lot. You know what I'm saying? Then shout out to Casino. He do a lot too. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all got any merch going? Because that sounds like something y'all could do a little merch thing going.
Word, we do.
That's what it sounds
we
like.
Do. We got some sweatsuits and shit. We got some sweatsuits coming and whatnot. But everything's a process. And I'm trying not to move too fast because, like I said, I just hopped out the gate. I'm trying to soak it all in and get an understanding of what I'm getting into to begin with.
Right. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up. Word. Independent routes, what it sound like.
Yeah, exactly.
No majors.
What you say?
No major. Label, like if
you're
going to sign.
You know what? I don't want to put him out there, but it's a dude named Brad Stevenson from Atlanta Records. He been talking to me and whatnot. But like I said, I'm just chilling right now because, like he told me, you know, keep building it up. We want to see that grind first.
Right.
We're not just going to put you on.
Right. Exactly.
You want to see that grind. You know what I'm saying? The music game crazy nowadays. It ain't, you back then, you probably could just have one song like a Joe Bun, pump it up, and you on.
Right.
Nowadays,
you
really gotta work. They gotta see the fans, they gotta see the fan base, they gotta see the views, they gotta see all of that, or else they ain't gonna deal with you like that.
So with that being said, how many joints you think you gonna need for dumb dudes to really start saying, yo, this nigga Face? I'm about to make him that person.
I'm gonna be honest with you, the mixtape that I just finished up, it got like maybe 4 or 5 up there, and I think that they gonna do numbers. As a matter of fact, I got maybe 2 that's out right now. We ain't even starting to push them. They popping where I'm at, feel me? I did about, like I said, in 3 weeks, I did like 4 or 5 shows already. But once I put it out there, like on iTunes, Spotify, I feel like it's going to take off on its own.
So you confident in this tape right here?
Yeah, in my first one.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Nice.
That's what's up.
Any collabs you probably would definitely want to like link with? Who inspired you from Jersey, though? That's what I really
want
to know.
As far as Jersey? You know what's funny? I never really even listened to the rappers.
From Jersey.
I never really listened to rappers, period. If it wasn't like a Jay-Z, or I really didn't listen to rappers, period. I just start catching up with 50 Cent and all of them. Like,
well, so you don't listen to none of this new shit then?
Nah. Actually, I do. I listen to Lil Uzi. I listen to a couple of them, but it ain't like I'm a fan. Like I said, I'm a fan of like a P&B Rock or Bryson Tiller, something like that.
Okay. Who your top 5 then?
If I had to say I had a top 5, because you know.
So they got like a top 2 off
the. Right. That's what it sounds like.
Top 2 already.
Like you just said Jay-Z 50.
Word.
Now I'm curious to know like.
A top 5 in general or top 5? In general,
I'm not
gonna listen in the order because that's, you know, depending
whoever
on
your top
who
five
this
is.
In the future.
It's not like I'm saying you like who's greatest. It's who's your top five, your go-to.
My top five go-to, Drake, that's number one. That's another one who, if y'all had to say somebody inspire me, it's the way that his flows mix up a lot.
That's a good pick.
So that'd be my first one. Like I said, Bryson Tiller, that's a go-to, that's a must. P&B Rock, that's a must. Lil Uzi Vert, that's a must. And probably last but not least, probably go with like Fabulous.
That's ill. Fabulous loving that. Like, yeah, the youth got him.
Right. Right. That's how I'm about to say. That's a good pick, though.
You know, the thing is, though, how many is still adapting to the youth like Fab is? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, for real. Whoa. Like, most is just grown men and youth niggas
it's
just fuck
few,
with it.
But that shit get overlooked.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's what's up though. So you with the freestyle? You with the smoke or no?
Well, yeah, I am. Probably not right now though, cause we was hectic today. Uh-huh. See, like next time I probably come up here, I probably definitely go 5 minutes for you.
I mean, you all only like a month in, so you know my fault.
Nah,
you might need a little bit more time and shit. I don't know.
We gotta catch him in grind mode.
Listen,
no haircut.
I had to catch him off the Henny. If he'd have been off the Henny, nigga, he probably have been ready. Like, fuck that, I'll freestyle. I'll give a fuck.
Catch me when we get here early. And I'm not rushing on to the next thing.
How was that show, too?
The last one I did, it was legit. That was what, Thursday, I think? It was legit.
Nice.
It was going crazy for that.
How the ladies been treating you since you told them about your debut?
I've been getting some attention. Like it's been there. Like I said, it's a grind, it's a process. 3 weeks in, you never really to say too much. Like I said, just to be up here again, this opportunity. 3 weeks in, going into a month, says all they have to say. Five shows, you know.
And your numbers, you say you're doing numbers, so
they
I mean, high.
They high.
For yeah. I mean, niggas has been in the game years now.
Probably don't got nothing.
This is what I'm saying. So they looking like, bro, fuck you mean that's all right? Nigga, I've been trying to hit 11,000 for the last 3 years, motherfucker. Put out 2 albums in the mixtape. The fuck?
At that point, it's probably not for you. You ain't doing the numbers.
Yeah, well, nigga, like, I got to come up with a dance move. That's what it is.
But, that's what it is.
For niggas in the studio, like, I got it. Yeah. The dance moves is
it. You got any more upcoming shows?
I think we got one. Because, you know, we got one at 27, right? Yeah. We got one at 27.
Word. It's in Jersey?
Nah, it's in Word.
Okay.
Word. And then I got, like I said, the nightclub scene. We do that. I probably do maybe, it's a block party I might do in my town. But it all depends what the money like. If it ain't right, it ain't right.
Are you getting paid already?
Sometimes.
Niggas is about to start hating on you, right. Son. Word about that. Like, niggas is about to. This nigga getting paid.
3 weeks.
My second time.
Niggas is like, I'm still paying for showcases. This nigga don't even give me red carpet treatment when I come in. Motherfucker, gave you $250. Wrong with you? Like,
next time he comes back, he gonna have bodyguard.
What college you was at again?
Well, first I was at Monroe. I went to Monroe first. Yeah, New Rochelle. I had a scholarship. I ran track pretty well, you know, so I was a good track runner and whatnot.
Yeah.
And what happened was, you know, I wound up having my son and whatnot, and then I decided not to go to Minnesota. And I stuck around with New Rochelle, and then I wound up transferring out of there, following my major with the pharmacy gig and the nursing, take care of my son and whatnot.
I mean, you got to think wisely sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It's not all about, I mean, because you definitely want to go for your goals, but you got to have a safety net at all times, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Yeah, for real. Definitely. Nice. Let's play one of them motherfucking songs and shit. Can we get one of those?
Yes, sir.
About to take a little brizzy break, you dig?
BBA Radio, call us up. We're
gonna come back with that bald face. Then we got another guest in the motherfucking building.
Mark
Lee. It's a crazy day, god damn it.
You're all ready.
BBA Radio.
That was, you had some,
that shit was coming, you know what I mean? Like, I ain't gonna lie. That shit is like already. For a nigga that's been doing music for a motherfucking month, I think you lying now.
Nah.
This nigga might be lying, y'all. I don't know. That's probably his way to get further. Like, I only did it for like a month. Type shit, because that shit was sounding like you already know what you're doing.
Got good engineers, man. That's what that is. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? Me and what I already.
Was it like was it one take type shit? You're talking shit right now. Like.
Nah, I try not to do that. I try and stay humble. But it was kind of one take for the no rule. the filling it and fucking with me. It was all one takes.
That fucking with me tough. That fucking with me tough, man. I like that one. I had a little sound to it. Who produced that?
This dude named Hani. He from Nigeria. He went to Yale, but now he own his own studio.
That's what's up. Networking underground shit, man.
So y'all got your own in-house studio.
Well, I got two. Like I said, I go to House of Music, where he work at, and he work with G-Eazy when he not doing his tours and whatnot. And then I got my personal engineer, Crispy. Shout out to him. He come through to the crib, and he always, whenever I want to do something, he there, you know what I'm saying, just to put it down, just thoughts, because you never know what could happen with the tracks.
So you got plugged. That's why you started rapping.
Yeah. No, I ain't. Why? Like I said, when I finally came out and wasn't being shy about it, it was like, oh, you got a chance. Like, I remember I'm going to keep it real with you. I was recording off of YouTube and with the phone, putting it with the recorded thing. Mm. And all that I was doing that over a recording over a YouTube thing. And I was sending it to my friends, like, just what you think, you know what I'm saying? If it's bad, let me know. Mm. And honestly, so far, I haven't really had no criticism on none of my music.
That's a grind, though, man. So like, word. Like, that's a grind right there.
Most I'm looking for a criticism, though. So I can know what it's built.
You need those.
I need it. I'm looking for it.
Right. I'm be real with you, though. It's probably nothing to say, really, so far. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
when I heard this shit, I'm like, it sounds like, funny you said Bryson Tiller, because that's the lane it's at. It ain't bad at all. It's like, this shit could work.
And, nigga, you've been doing this for a month. That shit could have been bad.
That's the crazy.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit could have been like, what the nigga? You did that? You ain't posted yet, right? Like, you ain't post that, did you? Oh, all right.
Like, who these niggas?
Don't even post that, my nigga. Like, go back to the drawing board with that one. Like, we gonna hit the chill button on that shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? But yo, let everybody know where they can find you, social media wise, any upcoming shows, SoundClouds, Twitters.
Well, on Instagram, you can follow me at @facenocase_. Twitter, the same, @facenocase_. Far as SoundCloud, same thing, @facenocase_. I made it pretty easy. It's a team name, @facenocase_, for everything, pretty much. As far as shows coming up, I think I got two more, one in Elizabeth. And like I said, I might do the block party in my city. Everybody already know about that, though. As far as like where I'm from.
Well, that's sad, because we might want to, shit, I might pull up. The fuck?
That's on the main. That's down there. You
know what I'm saying? It be lit? What is it, like the second annual, third annual? Like,
it's extra lit.
Okay. No, I'm saying, like, how many years y'all going on with, or is this the first year, first annual?
As far as what?
The party that you
it's going to be the first time.
Oh, what? Oh, okay.
Usually they throw something else, like a basketball tournament, where like you'll get the Fuquans, Edwins, and all of them coming out. TJ Maxx, they'll come out there and be balling.
Okay.
But they asked me did I want to do it. I said, I'll see.
Nice. Case in the motherfucking building. You already know, Paterson, New Jersey. It's a pleasure, brother. Appreciate you, man.
Thanks for coming.
You already know,
gotta
man.
Come back when you put that tape out. Too.
Don't get Hollywood on us, man. Because
you already shoot us his videos too, baby.
This nigga been productive in a month. I can imagine 5 months. Might get on this bullshit.
Nah, man. I'm just working, man. That's all it is. I would love to be back.
Keep doing what you do, man.
People that had me here, so it's like I'm really grateful.
Of course, brother. You see the grind. You already know what it is.
Right.
Chill.